You are watching BPDTV.
Good afternoon. I'm Detective Donny Moses. Welcome to BPDTV. Today is Thursday, March 29th, and here's what's going on with the Baltimore Police Department today. This morning, just after 2 a.m., officers responded to the 900 block of Valley Street for a report of a shooting. Once there, they found a 25-year-old male suffering from a gunshot wound to the face. That victim is now in serious condition at an area hospital. Anyone with information is asked to contact police. If you wish to remain anonymous, you can dial the Metro Crime Stoppers hotline at 1-866-7-LOCKUP. You may be eligible for a reward of up to $2,000. Detectives have arrested 25-year-old Trayvon West in connection with a shooting that occurred in May of 2011 in the 3800 block of Ricestown Road. At that time, Trayvon West walked up to a vehicle and shot a 26-year-old woman who was sitting in her car. West has been charged with first-degree attempted murder and handgun violations and is currently at central booking awaiting trial. On March 27, detectives from the Northeast District's Violent Crime Impact Section conducted a narcotic investigation in the 5700 block of East Berry Avenue. The initial investigation led to a home in the 4700 block of Shamrock Avenue where detectives executed a search and seizure warrant. Recovered was a .357 caliber handgun, 111 grams of heroin, and over $10,000 in cash. In all, four people were arrested, including 30-year-old Landon Gibson. All suspects were charged with weapons violations and drug trafficking charges. The Baltimore Police Department is currently accepting applications for an upcoming police academy class. The civil service test is given here at police headquarters every Tuesday at noon and 6 p.m. Find out more information by visiting our website at baltimorepolice.org or by calling 1-877-PRIDE-PD. Also, we have a cop walk again tonight to tell you about. The Audubon Community Association is having a cop walk at 7:30 p.m. They're meeting at the Old Audubon Methodist Church located at Conway and Sharp Street. Come on out, it's a good way to get involved, see what's going on in your community. It's a good way to interact with the police officers who patrol your area. So at this point, tell everyone, follow the Baltimore Police Department on Twitter, keyword Baltimore Police, for real-time crime updates. You can also watch past episodes of BPDTV 24 hours a day by visiting our website at baltimorepolice.org. For BPDTV, I'm Detective Donny Moses. Thank you for watching.
You are watching BPDTV.